This problem, we're calculating the pH of a solution that contains both ammonia and an ammonium salt, ammonium chloride. And we're given the volumes of the two solutions that we mix together. We're also given the base ionization constant, essentially a type of equilibrium constant for ammonia reacting with water. First thing we want to do is determine the starting concentrations before the reactions take place. The starting concentrations when we mix these two together. And so what we have is 0.1 molar, so 0.1 moles per liter of the ammonia salt, which is going to dissociate, and we're going to assume complete dissociation. Make this ammonium ion. And now what we want to do is first determine the number of moles. So we have 5 milliliters because the units 10 to the third milliliters is a liter. Now we have the number of moles of the salt. This number of moles is going to be finally in 55 milliliters. And again, keep the units correct. 10 to the third milliliters is liter. Now if we look at units and cancel units, what we're going to end up with is the concentration in moles per liter, or molar. So 9.09 times 10 to the minus third molar of ammonium ion from the salt. Now if we look at the pattern, we can make the calculation of the ammonia. What's its concentration in the mixture? And what we see we've done, we've multiplied by number of milliliters of this solution, the NH3 solution, divided by the total milliliters. So this is going to give us the molar concentration of ammonia. Once we have these two, we can look at the reaction, because what's happening is then ammonia plus water in equilibrium, ammonium ion plus OH, and this base dissociation constant, KB, is 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. Now, in some textbooks, the units are written with this. The unit, in this case, would be molar. And some, it's left out, but essentially assumed. So those are the starting conditions, and the water concentration essentially is not changing. It's not entering into equilibrium. The OH concentration would just be water before we look at dissociation. So that's insignificant relative to these values. So what's going to happen now is some ammonia will react. This value would increase, and the hydroxide concentration, equilibrium we're going to calculate is the ammonium ion concentration at equilibrium, the OH concentration over the ammonia concentration at equilibrium. That's going to be 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. And if we put the numbers in here, so typically a way to make a pretty good approximation, let's try this. We'll assume X is small relative to 9.09 times 10 to, and this is a minus here, 10 to the minus 2, and also then it would be small relative to 10 to the minus 3. Let's try that and see if it's a good assumption. Because if we do that, then the numerator, 9.09 times 10 to the minus 3 times x, 9.09 times 10 to the minus 2. This says x is 1.8 times 10 to the minus 4. Well, that's a pretty good approximation, significantly less than 1% error relative to 9.09 times 10 to the minus 2. It's not such a good assumption here. So what we could do is get a better answer by 9.09 times 10 to the minus 3. Let's add the value we calculated and then calculate a new value. We're still going to ignore it in the denominator. It's a pretty good approximation, times x, again 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. If we do this calculation, we get slightly different answer, better approximation, and we'll go with that. So this is the OH concentration in molar units. The problem asks us to calculate the pH. And so that means we need to go back and look at the equilibrium, OH minus and H3O plus and water, 1.0 times 10 to the minus 14 at 25 degrees C. This is sometimes referred to the ion product. And again, we could put in units. We know the OH concentration. We're solving for the H3O. So if we do the math here, the OH plus concentration, 5.68 times 10 to the minus 11 molar. So I can calculate the pH minus the log, base 10, of the concentration H3O plus. So that's minus the log, base 10, 5.68 times 10 to the minus 11. This is, so 10.25.